Let's go and see that how this will work out for a third order polynomial. So let's suppose we have chosen x naught, y naught, x1, y1, x2, y2, and x3, y3. So somebody gives us, so we choose four data points, and we want to see that how the third order find the third order Newton's divided difference polynomial. So if somebody asks us that, hey, okay, I've chosen four data points, can you find out the third order Newton's divided difference polynomial? How would I go about doing that? And I'm going to show this to you as a tree of divided differences, because that's the way we're going to show the example in the next segment. So let's go and look at this on the next board here. We have x naught here, we have x1 here, we have x2 here, and we have x3 here. So we are given the value of the function at three data points, and those values are given to us as f of x naught, f of x1, f of x2, and f of x3, which means the same thing as this is same thing as y naught, this is same thing as y sub 1, this is same thing as y sub 2, and this is same thing as y sub 3. There's no difference between the two things. We write it in terms of the f function because that's the way it is written in most books. So in order to keep it simple, we just write it in terms of that y is a function of x and it's given to you at these four data points. Now, the tree which I was talking about is that what's going to happen is that we already know that this is going to be the value of function, value of the function at B naught. So we already know that this is going to be the value of the function at B naught. But what's going to happen is that these two numbers here will give you the bracketed function of x naught comma x1. And that is nothing but, let me write x1 comma x naught, although there's no difference between the two, but just to follow convention and to keep things simple and uncomplicated. This will be the bracketed function, the first divided difference between the values of the function x1 and x0, and that is b1. So somebody might say, hey, okay, and I can find b2 by going down the tree, but you need another first divided difference here. So that's why you have to calculate all of these. You're going to calculate the divided difference between x2 and x1. Then you're going to calculate the divided difference between x3 and x2. So you can calculate the first divided differences of all of these types, although you know that this is the only one which you're going to use for B sub 1. That doesn't mean that the other ones which you're calculating are for no good reason. The reason why that is so is because when you're going to do this, you're going to get the divided difference now for X2, X1, and X0. And that is nothing but B sub 2. Again, you're going to calculate the divided difference between these two data points, which will be nothing but f of x3, x2, and x1. And the reason why you're calculating this is because you'll have to go between these two and calculate the divided difference of x3, x2, x1, and x0. And this is nothing but a b sub 3. So that's how it's going to work out when I'm going to show you the example for a third order polynomial. And also the reason why I'm showing it like this is because that's how you'll be writing this program algorithmically if you were going to write a subroutine or a function for it in any language you may desire, because you'll have to write down the function like this, and then you have to calculate all the first divided differences which are shown here, then the second divided difference which are shown here, and the third divided difference shown here, and then you will choose this to be B naught, this to be B1, this to be B sub 2, and this to be B sub 3 in order to be able to having calculated all those coefficients. And this is the end of this segment.